and there was a great calm. But he said to them, why are you so fearful? How is it that you have no faith? And they feared exceedingly and said to one another, who can this be that even the wind and the sea obey him?
All right.
The King James Version says, what manner of man is this? Hallelujah. Amen. So if I were to use the subject, it would have to be, what manner of man is this? He came to earth as a tiny, weak, and helpless baby, born to a simple, humble young girl who miraculously conceived a child. She had never slept with any man. In fact, the news of her pregnancy was so shocking that when the man to whom she was engaged to be married learned about it, he decided to break off the engagement, call off the wedding, until a powerful celestial being intervened and instructed him to stay with her and raise this very special child. We need some divine interventions in our life so that when the difficult times come, amen, we will do what God has called us to do and not try to run away from what has happened in our life. We cannot be ashamed of what has happened in our life. If God allowed it to happen, it's for a reason. Amen. And we need a divine intervention to keep us on track. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. This was unprecedented. This should never have happened. This should never have occurred. My God. Hallelujah. But this young man was willing to stand in the gap. Oh, sometimes you got to stand in the gap for somebody. Amen. It might be a sister. It might be a brother. It might be a child. It might be a grandchild. But God called you to stand in the gap. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Somebody needs help. Somebody needs a word. Somebody needs direction. Somebody needs instruction. Somebody needs you to be right there. Hallelujah. And we want to back out of the situation. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. Whatever comes my way, amen. I'm walking, amen, according to how God called me to walk. Whatever comes my way, amen, God is going to help me to deal with it. God is going to see me through. God is going to cause it to work for my good. Hallelujah. And we got to start seeing things like that and quit allowing the enemy, amen, to trick us, and the enemy, amen, to sway us, and the enemy to throw us off course. Amen. In the good time and in the bad time, we shall serve the Lord God Almighty. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Although he was ordained and predestined to be a king. In fact, he was predestined to be the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He was not born in a palace with illustrious members of the court in attendance. Instead, he was born on the dirty floor of a barn in a manger among cattle and donkeys, and he laid to sleep in the animal's feed trough. Oh my goodness, this does not look like a good picture at all. This does not look like his name is coming out nice at all. My God, you're talking about the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords being born in a stable. This ain't looking good, but our God is able. Oh, glory. I said he's able to do even the impossible. Oh, blessed be his name. Amen. Bishop said, take the limitations off of God. Amen. Because he's God. And he's the limitless God. Hallelujah. The God of the impossibilities. Thank you, Jesus. His birth brought no recognition, honor, or great fanfare from the institutions and the governments of his day. However, on the night in the hillside, a motley group, amen, of poor shepherds were awestruck as a brilliant and almost blinding light burst upon them from the starry sky, and a host of angels filled the night. received divine intervention, said, glory to God in the highest. The child was in the lowest, but they said, glory to God in the highest, because he's the most kind God. Blessed be his name. The Lord. Yes. Hallelujah. Unsuspected to be born that way. Hallelujah. But it didn't matter. Doesn't matter where you came from. Doesn't matter if your mama was married or not. Thank God you are here right now. Thank God he wants to use you right now. Thank God he can use you right now. It doesn't matter. Oh, blessed be his name. Blessed be his name. Most traumatic things that happened to me and Bishop in our lives was when our daughter was sent to university, amen, 18 years old, we sent her away to university, she finished her first year, and then in the second year she got pregnant. My goodness, amen, we felt bad, amen, if I could have run and hid under a rock, if I could have stayed underneath the bed, amen, for about a couple of years, I would have been so glad. Amen. But I learned something in this Christian experience. Amen. If God brings it your way, amen, it's yours. And God is going to help deal with the situation. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Amen. We always want to see the negative side of something. But what about the positive side of something? Amen. Never gave his mother a day of trouble. She never had to go to the school for him. Do you hear what I'm saying? We were pondering on it the other day, and he has a couple of sisters. We said, but wait a minute. The sisters were always getting some licks. The sisters was always getting some belt. Amen. But this young boy never got a belt licking. My God. And he tells you, amen, that he's a preacher. He tells you that he's a bishop. He tells you, amen, what God is doing in his life. And he loves the Lord with all his heart. I said, if God brings it your way, hallelujah, then it's for you. Hallelujah. Deal with it. Because we serve a great, big, mighty God. Amen. We don't serve a pitiful God. We serve trust God. Amen. The good times and through the bad times. Amen. This ain't just about, you know, going through the lilies and going through the rose bush and going through all the little cute, pretty little nice stuff. What about going through the mire sometimes? Amen. The difficult areas. Amen. The areas where you know the enemy wants to bring you down. But you come out victoriously. Hallelujah. You come out and you're triumphing in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Because God is on our side. Makes a difference. I said, what manner of man is this? Oh, glory to God. Let me try to finish this. Oh, blessed be his name. Hallelujah. And so we see these shepherds coming to inquire. And then far away, the Bible deals with far away in the east, another herald appeared in the heavens as a bright star caught the attention now of some wise men. Amen. At first it was some shepherd boys, probably unlearned. Amen. But now, oh my God, hallelujah, he's bridging the gap. We got some wise men now. Hallelujah. This Jesus is for the learned and the unlearned. He's for the big and for the small. He's for the ugly and for the cute. He's for the black and for the white. Our God, hallelujah, has bridged the gap. Oh, help us, Lord. And so the star led him across these hundreds of miles of desert to the little town of Bethlehem. And they honored this young child. His earthly father was a carpenter, a hewer of wood. He conformed to our human ways of life and our customs, our language, so that he could understand us and he could learn to love us and appreciate us better and communicate with us on our lowly level. He saw our suffering and he had compassion. He longed to not only heal our sick and broken bodies, but to save our spirit. And when the time came to begin his life's work, he went about everywhere, the Bible says, doing good. He helped people. He cared for the children. He healed broken hearts. He strengthened tired bodies. He saved those who would believe in him. He preached a message. But he didn't just preach it, preachers. He lived. Oh, glory to God. Some of us can preach this word. Some of us know the scriptures by rote and memory. But we can't live 5 cents worth of it. We can't live 5 minutes of it. It's not about how much of the scripture you know. It's about how much you're willing to do. Putting up stuff on Facebook. The Lord is this. And trying to bring down the enemies and what have you. Ain't got no power. When you see their life, ain't got no power. Because you know them. And you know how they've been living. And it's a mess. But they always putting something on Facebook. I said it's not how much scripture you know. It's how much scripture you live. Big difference. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. He lived his message among the people. He ministered not only to people's spiritual needs. He spent time tending to their physical, their material needs. He miraculously healed them when they were sick, fed them when they were hungry, shared his life and his love with them. His religion was so simple that he said, you just must become like